thing, the trunk, you can't get it open back here. It requires a button, and the battery is in the trunk. So what we have to do is, when you see here, is open up the hood, have little places where you can put your jumpers. So that's done. Just open it normally. You are going to just hit the button like you always do to open the trunk, or you could use your key. Once back here, battery. It's a huge battery. Mercedes and BMW tend to use these batteries. They're the 94Rs. So you could use another common replacement. It's a 40R. A lot cheaper if you don't want to spend the extra $100 on the bigger version. It'll work just fine. So what we gotta do is we gotta remove it using a 10mm. Disconnect the ground wire first. Sorry about the moving camera, guys. Don't have the attachments to use the GoPro a little bit better. Very simple. Very simple to do. I can get it on there properly. Okay. There we go. We got it off. Bolt right there that holds the battery in place. So for that, you can try to use this, or you can go get a little ratchet. So let's go get a little ratchet. I don't know if you guys noticed, but look at that. We are in Phoenix, Arizona, and there is weather that is just crazy. So it's been raining these past few days. So right now, I don't know if you can see underneath that car, a little bit wet still. Here, we're going to use a little extension, a little 10mm bolt, you guys see right here. I should have an extension around here somewhere. I don't know where I left it. Found it! Off. Little clamp. So your battery comes with a little clamp right here, so you have to push on this to release it. So after it's released a little bit, all you have to do is pull it out. Oh, and the handle breaks. Okay. Looks like something might still be holding it. We have to loosen this a little bit more. Put that there. There you go. Comes right up. Make sure you hold it with two hands. These little handles, they're not too strong. Let's go ahead and do this. Place it in here. Back on just to keep the battery in place. It's still moving. Gonna be putting on this first. sure if these cars come with a security feature for the radio, but I left the jump box on just in case. That way the car is always getting a constant juice. So in case the original stereo does have a security lock in it, and you don't have the code, you won't have to need it. Well, most of the time that's when it happens. You don't have the code, you need to change the battery. You change the battery, you go back inside all happy. And then it turns out your stereo is locked and you can't listen to music. Terrible. Alright, let's tighten down. So, it has two different bolt spots. Depending on the size of the battery, I guess I know you're going to change the battery size. They put different bolt sizes so you can use this in a different area if needed. So let's go ahead and put that on there. And it's useless because this battery doesn't have a thing at the bottom, so you can tighten it on there, but we'll leave it in there just in case for the next person. They need it. And boom. Looks like we are ready. Goes out, goes back up, looks nice and clean. So that's where the battery is. That's how you change it. Somewhat, you know, I could have been a little bit more detailed, but that's the basics. Changing a battery isn't that difficult. Nobody can do it. Alright, guys, peace out.